Welcome back to Legend of Dragoon. Now, before I do my grinding that I've already talked about having to do, well, choosing to do, there is a couple of scenes that I wish to participate in, you know, including Lynn getting back home, his marriage, all that. You can actually see it. And I need to go to Lohan for something that's questionably important. Oh! Gates of Heaven. I don't remember what it does at all. Can you tell that I don't use the White Dragon, the White Dragoon very much? I mean, it's all about healing, but... It's the whole... Yeah, she's excellent at healing. It's just the trade-off. She's not... very good normally. I mean, her last spell is probably the most disgusting ability in the game. But when she's not a dragoon, she's kind of... Yay! Hopefully. Yeah, we're not getting rid of Miru that easily. She's like, no, you guys are interesting. We can, and we will. Three-ring circus? Why is it always a three-ring circus? Whenever someone talks about how silly it might be, why is it always a three-ring circus? Yeah, please come to our wedding, blah, 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 blah. It's tomorrow. Hopefully he's okay and doesn't get eaten on the way back. That would be... I'm sure Kate would appreciate her fiancé not being eaten. And also, the Barons. I told you, we're going to be coming here a lot. And just think, I've cut out most of it, haven't I? Donu, the Flower City. You don't have to do this, you can completely skip it, but we were invited. Why not, right? Hello? Oh, wow. Yeah, see, he said it was tomorrow, and it's like, we just ran here. It took, like, 30 seconds. What? They certainly had a fast marriage ceremony. Jeez. Rescuing Lynn was all, you know, like, bonus stuff, too. It's like, oh, we're going there anyway. Why not? But, we made a lady happy. He's happy he's not in prison anymore. And, well, hopefully they have a good marriage. That's important. Fire Kate's bouquet. I don't know who catches it if you don't push X. It might be Miru. Or Rose. Actually, I honestly don't even know. Now I kind of want to reload and do it again, but I don't have a convenient save. I should have thought of that beforehand. So I can at least show it. Although this isn't going up for... way in the future as I'm recording it, so I do have time. It's not like it took me long to get here. Uh, I still have things to do, and I already have a home. I mean, we did promise to return to Celes, didn't we? I'm pretty sure that happened. Thank you. Already? Okay. Wow, that quick wedding, she's already pregnant? Wow, of course, she never really mentioned if she was already pregnant, though. Hey, finally. But the next place to go is Lohan. Which means, you guessed it, the Barrens. I'm not going back to Fletz yet. I assume is that how it's pronounced. I am going to do that little spot near the Rock Fireflies where I mentioned, you know, that's a great place to work in addition. I am going to be doing that. So, and I wanted to go to Donu anyway since, well, that's where I'm going to be selling the poison needles, the angel prayers, the other random items I get along the way. Anyway, I'll meet you at Lohan. Actually, I suppose I could show, Shauna's third ability, can't I? That is a horrible camera angle. It just looks bad. Gates of Heaven, ally all 100% recover. Don't need it, but I should show it. So that's what that looks like. Woo. Not like I'll ever be using it. And oh yeah, Hashel still has 80 speed, which is incredible. Ha ha ha. Flurry of sticks, but it says fairy. And there's a lot of oversights in this game like that. It especially with Albert. / Lovitz. There's the one spell that is incorrect. Whichever. And I think his last ability is also the same way, his last edition. Ah, finally in Lohan. Took me long enough, sheesh. Seems every three steps I had to fight something. Remember him? Yes. Now, are you gonna try to rob me again? You know, the, like, 100 million gold for a glass jar. A stone? Yep. I don't know. The way Kongol gets his Earth Dragoon Spirit, or whatever the name actually is, seems kind of lame. I mean, everybody else either, you know, too much of a coincidence. Dart had it from, you know, his father's memento. I mean, it was the thing that, yeah. Hashel got his from a boss. Shauna got hers from Shirley, which we used it to save her life. Well, she used it to save her own life. Lovitz got it from Greham after getting revenge, finding out it really wasn't worth it, and, you know, closing that. And Albert got it from Lovitz's death, you know, as the knight's final gift to his king. Who am I leaving out? I feel like I'm leaving somebody out. But it's like, oh, yeah, Kongol's is in a street market. What? Shining Miracle Stone! Yeah, too bad it's only going to shine for Kongol. You can get Kongol's Dragoon Spirit for free later on. And by later on, I mean way later. Like, right now, we're somewhere in the middle of the second disc. Maybe. Probably on the early side. Like, legitimately. When you can get it for free, it is so late it's not even worth it. It's near the end of the fourth disc. Yeah. It's that far away. No, Rose. It's not worth it. So 1,000 gold for Dragoon Spirit. Well, honestly, if I'm going to use a Kongol at any point, one, I need a bandit training for him, which I have. Two, I need his Dragoon Spirit. And I don't think we can actually haggle him down from 1,000. I'm gonna try. Yeah. Honestly, if you really are penny pinching, just skip it. Just don't buy it. Because you probably won't be using Kongol anyway. Because honestly, can I talk to him, please? You need to give him a speed item. I mean, between him and Albert, yes, it's only 10 speed, but it really is a huge difference. Like, Albert will go twice and Kongol will go once. It's a big, big difference. Not to mention, you pretty much, other than a few fights, have to give Kongol a legend cast. So he's up to, Rose's or Shauna's magic defense. You really have to. Well, other than the 50% evade, I'm talking other than that. I'm talking raw number power. Not at this point. I mean, I'm talking about later, but yeah, I might as well get it. Golden Dragon Dragoon Spirit. Save that a few times fast. Have fun with that. So now, I can level his Dragoon form. Which, yeah, the SP gain on hit Kongol is probably, without a doubt, the slowest leveler. Because he's slow, if you don't have the bandit ring. You know, Shauna starts out really slow and then she gains speed. Right now she's level 3 Dragoon, she's gaining 70 SP per level, per attack, which isn't bad. Dart's getting like 75 from that. So I need to finish that. I probably will get his 5th one while doing it, because I'm going to gain a couple levels, it's inevitable. Probably, I think that one's at 22, or 21, maybe 23. It's somewhere in the early 20s, is what I'm trying to say. I'm going to finish Rose entirely. I mean, more is almost done. I have Hardblade, which isn't going to take that long, and, you know, finishing those three will give her a 4th. The 4th one is brutally hard. Possibly, it's definitely in the top 3 hardest additions. I mean, as far as I remember, Dart's 7th one is not that difficult. It's just long. Rose's is pretty damn hard. Haschel's is pretty difficult, I think. Albert's is really difficult. Kongol's is a laugh. The 3rd one, yeah, he only gets 3 additions. He also only gets 3 spells, I believe. Like, one, he's got one now, he'll get one at level 2, and then he has to wait all the way to level 5, I believe. His second one might come at 3, but I doubt it. And Miru, who right now, at the moment, I have no intention on working on, since she's not a Dragoon. Oh, I'm gonna have to put in, little clips of all these additions that I'm not gonna show in the regular playthrough, aren't I? Just to show them for completion's sake, not to mention spells like Kongol's, which, you know, other than a couple of fights that I can think of, I'm really not going to use him. Maybe for wandering around? Like, just fighting normal enemies, put Bandit's Ring on him and he's fine. For, you know, getting from A to B. He's useful because he's got lots of HP, at 50 speed, he's at the same as Dart. So, you know, he's pretty good from getting to A to B, but bosses? Bosses? No! He's absolutely the worst character to bring to a boss fight unless you give him a legend cast. Especially some of them later that just do nothing but spew magic at you. Yes, there's actually a lot of those. It's actually the majority of the boss fights. Anyway, enough rambling. Montage here, I guess, of spells and additions go? And buying a legend cask, probably, since I have like 5,000 gold now, and I'm probably going to get about 13, 14,000 grinding up my additions. Maybe not that much, but I'll definitely be able to afford one legend cask. Yes. You know what? What the hell? I will show what happens when you don't push the X button. Why not? You know, I'm curious enough. I want to see what happens. Yay. Okay, RPG. No pressing buttons. I just want to know who ends up catching it. My money... I think it's Rose. I honestly don't remember. I know I've seen it before. But I don't... It might be Miro. Meru. Or however it's supposed to be pronounced. I think someone mentioned that, Japanese pronunciation is Meru. Which, Meru, meh, it doesn't matter. What, it's Hatchel? Damn. Well, at least you'd be more clothed. Yeah. Oh, those two. You still end up with it. No matter what happens, you still end up with Kate's bouquet. It doesn't do anything. But I guess that was worth doing. I thought it was either Meru or Rose that ended up catching it. Meru would want it, you know, right there. I want to be in my wedding dress. And Rose would have been like, are you serious? Really? It flew to me. Anyway, my grinding is done, thankfully. Although I need to go and record little bits of all the things that I'm not going to end up using in the rest of the game. Because, well, Kongo's spell abilities, for example, I'm... No. If he's using Dragoon form... He's going to be using his normal attack, because I don't remember the percentages, but at the moment the Dragoon percentage adding, it, you know, 2 times 40 isn't impressive as 1.5 times 140. It's not even close. Other than that, just a few additions. You know? And Rose and Albert are completely done. As far as additions go. And, yeah, they're... You get to see some, top-end additions. They are just disgusting. Especially Rose's. I believe... Well, you'll see it eventually anyway, the next time I use her. Her ability, her last addition... If you have her ultimate weapon, which is not going to be for a very, very long time, she does the most damage in the game, I believe. Like, just with that and her final edition, because her final edition's like 500%. Yeah, and her last weapon is just disgusting. I think it's plus 100 attack. Yeah. Yeah. Oh, boy. Yeah, this is before I started grinding. The grinding's done, though. Thank goodness. Alright, time to show some abilities. Kongol, who is not level 5 yet on his Dragoon Spirit, but I maxed out his first edition, and that was, you know, it's like that, I'm done. He's gonna get one in his second one in 23? I think. And yeah, he hurts. That was just the, I think it's increased by 150%. Yeah, that is very impressive. That, and I think he has the bandit's ring on right now. Nah, I always jump the gun on that one. That's fine, because that's not Albert's Ultimate Edition. His Ultimate Edition, I am much, much better at. I actually find Gust of Wind Dance, which is that one, to be a lot easier than his Ultimate one. I really do. Did I say that in the wrong order? I meant his Ultimate Edition is easier than his penultimate one. Did I say it in the right order? I'm not sure. I don't know, Kongol's transformation just fits him so well. It's just amazing, I think. Yeah, the nice thing about Kongol's, all his magic hits everything. It's just, you know, his magic stat is crap. And I think at the moment he's getting like 210% to his magic stat, which is only 48. And 160 to his physical, which is 144. Yeah, not going to be using his magic too much. 970. Oh, that's wind based, that's why. Wow, Kongol! That was actually rather impressive. I didn't expect the almost 1,000 damage. Yikes. And here I try again. At least with these, I don't have to worry about being counterattacked. Gust of Wind Dance, decent amount of damage, but crap on the SP. Which is, well, predictable. Yep, 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 yep. There is no reason to use that. Because, one, I have his Ultimate Edition, which is better in every single way possible. And I think it's easier. Personally, I do believe it's easier. And also, Darts picked up Madness Hero, which is a huge amount of SP, which you will be seeing later, because there are uses for that. And yeah, this. Very, very difficult to pull off, but holy crap, is it worth it. Anyway, I don't know, Kongol in his Dragoon form just looks silly, but anyway, Meteor Strike to everything, and that little birdie thing's going to take a ton of damage. Mr. Windbased in the middle there. Yeah, watching Kongol's abilities seems very strange because I never use them. Ever. There's no reason to. Unless you give him a legend cast, and even in that case, 1298, wow. Even in that case, I don't remember the actual number it adds. And as you can probably see from my money total, I need to go buy one. And I'm full on items. No. No? Please discard. There's no use for it. His spells, there isn't. They're garbage. But anyway, more things to show. I guess I should show the summon abilities of the people that I do have them for? The ultimate spells? Yeah, they're not useful. Not most of them. A couple of them here and there are useful. You guys counterattack. The thing about Demon's Dance, what makes it hard, is one, the timing's pretty bad. The second one is there's three or four places that Rose can get counterattacked, and one of them's in a really easy place. The rest are in horrible, horrible places. And I messed up anyway. Even if you screw up Demon's Dance, the damage is actually still worth it. It's actually kind of amazing. Nah, I might as well show Darts. Why not? not like there's much left of this. You're going to see Final Burst a lot. I mean, I'm pretty sure I showed those two already. I think I showed Final Burst already. But, Red Eye Dragoon, 175% damage to all. Now, you can imagine the kind of damage that this could do if Dart initiated special. And has a Legend Cask on. It's actually pretty ridiculous. Although, unless you equip an amulet, you're only getting one cast, and then you have to get everything back. And I don't know what it is about Red Dragon. It reminds me of something, but I can't place it. Weren't those guys darkness-based, too? Yeah, 500-some-odd damage. They only have about 200-300 life? Maybe. Something that doesn't counterattack. Well, if it does, it does it very, very rarely. This will be a good opportunity to show Demon's Dance. You're going to see it anyway, but I want you to see the damage that is associated with this. Demon's Dance. 450. Oh, boy. I think she does almost as much as Albert at the moment. I really do. What's her attack stat at the moment? ...80? And does about the same as Albert, who has 99. Wow, you two have exactly the same offense. Chana and, Meiru. Meiru. I'm probably going to end up start saying Meiru, even though, well, I was told it was the correct one, so, is that. I still need to show two more summons, don't I? And all of Albert's spells that I never, ever will cast, because the only thing that's worth casting on him is Blossom Storm. Alright, Albert, you might as well go for the Jade Dragoon. Dragon, 75% to all. Again, all I'd use is Blossom Storm. Everything else is just not worth it. You know, that's the thing that felt a little bit weird playing this game the first time. Seeing all the dragons and, you know, what is usually portrayed as dragon, the reptilian, lizard-like creature with wings. You know, anything. When you see a normal dragon, like the ones that were in Might and Magic, that's what I expected, but that's not what I got. So it was a little bit strange, because they're not really all that. Some of them aren't really. They don't appear to be reptilian in any way. Like that one. Lethal attack for all never works. This guy's darkness based, isn't he? Yeah, Rose's is a little bit creepy, I think. Although, you know, once the shadow comes out and forms the dragon, it's like, what? Some of them are very interesting. Like, I like how the red one looks, even though it reminds me of something that I can't place. But some of them just look terrible. The Jade Dragon is in the really in the middle. It looks kind of funky, but I like it. The Darkness one is just kind of bleh. Then again, these are going to be the only times you see these in this playthrough, unless, you know, something happens. And yes, there's a reason I'm doing it here, because free MP, yay! Oh, I gotta show Demon's Gate, don't I? Have I shown Wing Blaster? I don't know. But really, that's the only spell you have to worry about for Alva. That's the only one, like, worth mentioning. I never really used any of the other spells. Meh. Meh. And Demon's Gate, once I don't go buy it.
Demon's Gate.
There is so much symbolism in that, no, no, no. That's just so wrong on so many levels. I've forgotten what the skill looks like. And it actually worked! yeah, apparently she eats them with that part of her anatomy, I guess. And there is so much wrong with that. This feels really awkward. Anyway, did I show the rest of Hashel's spells? The ones I do have? I'm not sure. Anyway! Summon Four Gods is 100 SP, 100% damage. It is... meh. If it was more SP, it would be a really nice ability. But the whole... yeah. I mean, at least darts. Madness Hero gives you over 200 SP. The number in the single digit doesn't really matter. It's... airs. But, you know, that's two turns as a Dragoon. Given the right circumstances, that's great. Hashel, nah. I don't know, Hashel. I just don't know. Okay, have I shown Wing Blaster? I don't know. Well, if I haven't, I have now. Just, you know, covering all the bases, making sure. Ultrasonic is really annoying. Especially when they do that. It's really funny watching a Dragoon run away. So that takes care of Albert. The only person I have really left is Shauna. Well, I didn't work on Meiru at all. Meiru. Didn't even touch her. Because, well, meh? She doesn't have a Dragoon spirit, maybe? Yeah, you have Thunder God, and yeah, literally, every one of his spells are single targets. Even the summon one at the end, they're all single, I think, are all single targets. They're just... meh. It's alright, I guess. It's not worth what, you know, whatever. But anyway, Shauna reached max Dragoon Spirit level. Yeah, it also grants her access to this. Light Strength, 100% all HP. Yeah, it murders your foes with light damage. Remember how high her magic stat is. And it completely heals the party. Without a doubt, the most, pretty much, well, I can't think of anybody that could argue that that is pretty much the most powerful attack in the game. Completely murders your foes, the 2244 being on, you know, the darkness, blood-sucking parasite guy. And, yeah, that is just brutal. There is a boss later that is all, comes with multiple pieces, or enemies in the fight, and casting that once will end the fight. Yes. Uh-huh. I'm gonna show that fight both ways, though. I'm gonna show it the... not using Shauna, and using Shauna with a legend cast. Just because, why not? Anyway, ignoring ultimate abilities of ultimateness, have I shown Gates of Heaven? I don't know, let's just go ahead and do so. I've shown Star Children, right?
God, give me power! Gates of Heaven!
This ability is very loud, by the way. I might turn it down for you, because it is really, really, like, super loud in my ears. I've shown Moonlight, I've shown Star Children, right? And yeah, that is a 100% recover from 30. And that's just ridiculous. Just to make sure that I've shown this, I'm pretty sure that I have, though. I guess it's nice that there's more than one enemy. I think that takes care of everything. Everything that I need to show, everything that I wanted to show, just because, well, it needs to be done. You've already seen Flurry of Sticks? I think. Yeah, you have. Summon Four Gods is... meh. If there was more SP involved, that would be a really nice skill, but, you know, 100 and 100 is kind of meh. Saw Gusts of Wind Dance, Flower Storm, which I think when he attacks he says Blossom Storm, yay for discrepancies, and, well, I'm not working on you yet. Yeah, and I've showed everything on Kongol, everybody, yeah. I should be done. Yeah. Anyway, I'm not gonna I'm gonna go buy that Legend Cask. Not gonna use it, but I will be getting it. I need to switch people out. I meant to show me getting the Legend Cask, but I completely pushed the button. Good job, RPG. Yeah, I've bought the Legend Cask. Give you an idea. 110, 110. Done. Well, Shauna's the highest, I think, right at the moment. Yeah, it actually makes him respectable. And his attack is still lower than Shauna's, which is kind of funny. No, gee. Buttons are awfully sensitive. Yeah, 237 magic defense. And if she's in Dragoon form, I don't believe she can take magical damage. everything will do like one. Not to mention the 55% evade, which is just crazy. I mean, only half the attacks would hit her. And the ones that did, even if she's not in Dragoon form, would do almost no damage. That's the reason this is so... just a ridiculous item. I'm not going to use it for, like, normal bosses. I'm going to reserve it for mostly optional. Maybe occasionally I'll use them on a normal boss. Maybe. But, that's one. There is no reason for her to equip that. Anyway, this part has, like, ADHD, doesn't it? Like, this is all over the place. This is gonna be fun to edit. Oh, man, I can't wait for that. I don't even know how long this part is. I need to stop, edit this, and see how long it is if I want to actually go to Fleets and do the thing. So, if this is, you know, the middle of the part, I'll see you in Fleets. And if this is the end, until next time. Although saying that in the middle of a part is really awkward. But anyway, yes.